think that that might command like the
history of U.S. government whistleblower. But for the first time in history, a U.S. government whistleblower testified before Congress of the United States. But for the first time in history, and while you watch this testimony, the bodies recovered from crash, extraterrestrial beings. Congress of the United States government has in its possession. But for the first time in history, a U.S. government whistleblower testified before Congress that the United States government has in its possession extraterrestrial beings, yes, non-human pilot bodies recovered from the crash. And while you watch this testimony, I'm about to show you, remember that it is a federal crime to lie under oath before Congress. Very important people remember that. And the very thing that could put Dr. Kavanaugh behind bars for a
If you believe we had a
track
of either or not,
as I've stated before, non-human, that was the assessment of people of technology or the that are currently
stuck. This is soccer, video,
specific documentation I'm going to
What agency, what agency, what contractor, who should be called into the next hearing about the either
give you a specific cooperative so with specific individuals
My next guest is probably not a surprise. Any of his name is Dr. Steve Beard. He leads the Disclosure Project. He's authored multiple times. Subject. But he's known about this for decades. It's new news for him. Dr. Drew, welcome back to the show. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Great to have you here. So when you're watching this testimony, we all were really
close. Did you hear anything? You're a superior. That surprised you. That stood out to you. Did you not heard before? That stood out to you.
No, not really. You're out.
We should be clear, the reverse engineered craft that the United States Black Ops off the books projects have been reverse engineering these craft for decades. That's the predominant things that people are now seeing in the sky. But based on these alien craft originally.
Correct. And there are actually but I think that all that command asked about those other records that are rogue. So I think that our future that we're very much aware of. Is ancient to me what humans are doing and what we call it innate present. I think the complexity of that is very, in other words, in 1991, I think I was involved with a subject company. He says, if you tell the couple truthfully, so remember in 93, the doctor of psychological analysis of the UFO subject, 1985, CIA doc describing psychological operations in Brazil and Argentina that have been in abduction. Made to look like a thing. So when you do this, like Mr. Ross White and some of these congressmen who are just learning, they don't have the information that they're trying to get that you have to entertain two totally separate events. But there are potentially, you know, if you look at the reverse engineered human craft, we call them ARVs, or alien reproduction vehicles, or ATs, just advanced technology. Those MOAs are pretty close to the field, but in terms of maneuverability, and we've also created a state called abduction people. Now, why would that happen? Because they eventually want to sort of have a global militaristic totalitarian grip on the whole public about the needs of the alien invasion and like that. But that's been the wrong defense since the 1950s, 70 years on now, regarding the UFO issue. That's why they think by curating and developing all black operators on relations and events like that, and even the murdering that would all increase in access to South America. So that is real or flat. And I would tell the biggest part of the secrecy is what I just said. The next biggest is the fact we figured out how to do it. So we have a new one. We have an unpacked year of very long that the quest were to get secret because if they were released, there would be no need for oil, gas, or nuclear power. And so the interests that are maneuvering and manipulating the situation ordinarily have more assets and money than the entire U.S. government. I'll say that. And it's an existential threat. But luckily, the Senate is about a year ahead, and there are people who are there really. There are special projects going on that I can't say more about. We're involved with also making plans to correct the FDA, the leading robot operations in the field. One thing I want to add. If you are in, I know you don't know this, but you're very senior management, corporate, or government, if legitimate U.S. government and NPO I operation comes here, so you are to put your weapons down, you are not. Now, the reason I'm saying this is that the project I put out there is that gaslighting and sending to go on for another 50 years. So, I know for a fact that institutions have been reading some very high stakes that these operations are illegal and are threats to world security. But if you take the momentum of Johnny O'Connor, a very young guy, who was there for several years in the mid to late 20s, and was read out there to be an industrial and human operation, and also at Wright Patterson in Kenner. And, he had no idea that if operations reaches the management of those operations, those would not be, supervised, lead by the Congress. Now, I found that out because of the CIA director. I've had that statement for a time. But most people call them very highly classified that are in Canada. And they're not like we're all found out with the direct, like the disclosure part. They have no idea they're in the problem. They need to get this necessary because they are not understand that they have the problem. But at this point, read between the lines. The majority leader of the Senate is taking action against the body. This will be easy to grab. The vote is by Senate Intelligence, the Armed Services, senior people that are in the country. And grabbing face is sitting together. You can't have a acquiring next president, reverse engineering, developing advanced technologies, why like that, and do this all without oversight. If you do it that way, it is a rogue institution project. Because all of you working in those areas prepare to operate to the law that you want. Number two, if you are a whistleblower currently or in the past, please contact us on our website. We can put up this book.
Overall, when we saw members of Congress, though, asking some fairly nuanced questions, I couldn't actually believe. Here we were in 2023 with members of Congress asking questions about interdimensional beings in front of Congress. I mean, that's one thing to stand out for me. And David Grush kind of touched on that a little bit. There was other more nuanced questions about the kinds of vehicles, propulsion mechanisms. It wasn't sort of the laughing stock that we've seen in past hearings. They actually seemed like really interested in getting to the bottom of this. Just the interdimensionality question. What do you know about the interdimensionality piece that David Grush was asked about? Being traveling interdimensionally.
Well, the